keep hearing niggas saying I'm supposed to die tonight. Niggas don't put a hit out and they talking like this shit okay. What's good, y'all? It's the one and only Enwafina. If you guys enjoy NFL NBA content, this video, like it. If you're new, go and subscribe to the channel while you're at it. Now, let's get to it. Listen. Let's be about the Pittsburgh Steelers 2020 team preview. Check me out. Listen, this Pittsburgh Steelers team going 12-4. Listen. Y'all can say whatever the fuck y'all want to say. Y'all can say I'm overrating this team. Y'all can say, oh my goodness, Phenom, the Pittsburgh Steelers going 12-4. How dare you? The Pittsburgh Steelers are done. Big Ben is washed. Well, listen. It's funny y'all say Big Ben is washed, because the last time we seen Big Ben play a full 16-game season, he threw for 5,000 yards. He threw for 5,000 yards. I mean, we talking about quarterbacks, you know, people making their predictions of who's going to lead the league in passing yards. People just want to give it to Mahomes. People want to say maybe Deshaun Watson, maybe Carson Wentz, maybe this, then the third. But nobody wants to give Big Ben any love. Listen, man, I have my criticism of Big Ben. Listen, I criticize Big Ben as much as anyone. I shit on Big Ben when he got buried by Brady multiple times in the playoffs. I buried Big Ben when he lost to Blake Bortles in the playoffs. I buried Big Ben and Mike Tomlin when they lost to Tim Tebow in the fucking playoffs. But to say that this team isn't a playoff contending team is absolute ridiculous. This team, they're going to be great. The Pittsburgh Steelers is going to be great this year. Check me out. This team went 8-8, right? This team went 8-8 last year with Mason Rudolph and a quarterback named Duck Hodges as the quarterbacks. Fuck out of here. They're getting their Hall of Fame quarterback back. Their two-time Super Bowl winning quarterback back. Listen, Big Ben is going to take this team to 12 wins. Ain't nothing y'all can say about it. Y'all can't convince me otherwise. This team is going to be great. They're going to be contenders. How I look at things is this. Big Ben is coming back fully healthy. And maybe he even starts off the season slow. But this is why now you have an elite defense. This is the best Steelers defense that they have since damn near Troy Polamalu and Joey Porter and Ike Taylor was on the fucking squad. This is the best defense I've seen the Steelers have since then. So, with this defense being there, maybe they can carry Big Ben early in the season. Because, truth be told, yeah, does Big Ben not have AB? No. But, yeah, this kid named Deontay Johnson, who I think is going to be the next Steelers receiver to perform. Listen, I love AB. I do. At least I do on the field. Off the field, you know, it is what it is. But on the field, AB was like no other. AB was like no other. But we know the Pittsburgh Steelers, they growing receivers off of trees. This is what the Steelers do. I mean, look at AB, for example. Nobody knew who AB was when he got into the league. Before he knew it, he was the best receiver of the decade. Look at Hines Ward. Look at Santonio Holmes. Look at Mike Wallace. Look at all these Steelers receivers that they've grown. Deontay Johnson's finna be the next. People are back on the big Juju train. Listen, I like Juju. I think Juju is going to be solid in the slot, but Deontay Johnson by the end of the season is going to be the number one receiver. He's the next AB. He's going to catch over 1,000 yards. He's going to have around 90, 95 catches because, listen, this Steelers team is going to throw the ball a lot. Big Ben is going to be throwing the ball a lot. Listen, this running game isn't good enough for... Listen, how can I say it? James Conner, he ain't a bum. James Conner not a bum, okay? Don't get it twisted. He's not a bum, but he's not Le'Veon Bell. Okay, if Le'Veon Bell was on this team, okay, maybe the Steelers pound that ball 20, 25 times a game. But James Conner is not Le'Veon Bell. Okay, so at the end of the day, Big Ben's going to be airing that bad boy up. From all reports I'm hearing, that shoulder's looking good. The ball velocity is still there. So I expect Mike Tomlin and Big Ben to be airing that ball up. So I expect Deontay Johnson to eat. I'm looking at around 90 and 95 catches, over 1,000 yards. Listen, Deontay Johnson is one of my fantasy sleepers. You guys know this. You guys know this. Listen, if you guys haven't been checking out my fantasy content, you guys make sure y'all check that out. All right? So you can catch these gems. All right? Catch these gems like Deontay Johnson's going to be catching tubs from Big Ben all season. All right? So, you know, overall, I'm big on the Deontay Johnson trade. You drafted a hybrid receiver slash tight end, Chase Claypool. It looks like they're going to list him at wide receiver, which I like because he played receiver all in college at Notre Dame. So keep him as a natural position. You can use him as a big receiver. He's going to be good in the blocking game. Should be good in the red zone. I like it. Like I said, you still got Juju, who's going to be a lot in the slot. I like it right now. I really do. Now, the X factor is James Washington. But James Washington was supposed to eat last year. So, you know, James Washington, you know, if he's any good, then we could be talking about a really good receiving core. You know, this offensive line, of course, is going to be top 10 regardless. David DeCrasto. You still got my man, what's his name, Alexandro. And you got Marquise Pouncey. Yeah, it's still going to be a top 10 O-line. It's not going to be the prime 2016-2017 Steelers offensive line, but it's going to be good. It's going to be good enough for Big Ben to get have enough time to air that ball out. You brought in my man Eric Ebron, who's a red zone machine. He's a touchdown machine. I mean, 2 years ago, Eric Ebron caught 15 tubs from Andrew Luck. So who knows? Now he's playing with a really good quarterback again. He's most likely going to see double-digit touchdowns again. Vance McDonald. Listen, I like it. I like it. I just wish they had Le'Veon Bell. I really do. Listen, Adam Gase has shown multiple times that he does not like Le'Veon Bell. Listen, on the Steelers, put your pride aside. Steelers players, I know what y'all said to Le'Veon Bell. Oh, we don't need Le'Veon Bell. James Conner will get it done. Listen, this team had electric running back who can run out the backfield and catch passes out the backfield, who can line up in the slot. I don't know a team that can mess with this team, truth be told. If this team sells Le'Veon Bell, this team might go 14-2, truth be told. So, I wish the Steelers could put their pride aside, but it looks like they're finna roll with James Conner, so it is what it is. But, you know, that this offense is looking lit. Cameron Hayward, TJ Watt, Bud Dupree, Devin Bush. We know how this front seven is going to get down. Steven Tuitt. Listen, this front seven is damn near as good as any front seven in the entire National Football League. TJ Watt, Bud Dupree is going to get after the passer. Cameron Hayward is going to plug up the middle, get after the passer. Same for Stephen Tuitt. I mean, it's a Pittsburgh Steelers defense. I mean, what are we talking about? It's the steel curtain. I mean, ain't nothing really to talk about. The Pittsburgh Steelers are defense. When you think of the Steelers, you think of defense. 3-4 defense. There you go. Hardcore 3-4 defense. Ain't nothing really to get around. And then, not to mention, they got the secondary to go with it. You got Joel Hayden, who's still balling. Joel Hayden is still playing like a beast for some reason. Steven Nelson had a really good year last year. Mike Hilton's going to lock up the slot. And then, not to mention, you made a trade last year for Minkah Fitzpatrick, who, you know, turned out to be one of the breakout players of last season. You know, turning himself into a top 10 free safety. Now, have Steelers fans overrated him by calling him the best free safety in the NFL? Yeah, you bugging. There's no way Jamal Adams is the best pure safety in the NFL. You out your mind. Jamal Adams can't play in the box. He's not versatile enough. And, you know, he's not physical enough to be the best safety. He's not messing with Jamal Adams. He's not messing with Harrison Smith. Truth be told, he's not really messing with, what's our man in Tennessee, Kevin Byard. So, I mean, Minkah Fitzpatrick is cool. I like his versatility. You can play him in the slot. You can play him at deep safety. I think he's dope at that. But let's cut it out real quick. Let's cut it out. He's not the best safety in the NFL. But, like I said, man, this might be the best pure defense in the NFL. Like I said, man, this is still curtain. You got your Hall of Fame quarterback back. Mike Tomlin has never had a record below 500. Y'all need to start showing Mike Tomlin some love. I criticized Mike Tomlin in the past for losing games in the playoffs that he shouldn't have lost. But At the end of the day, this guy, Mike Tomlin, has shown year by year in the regular season, no matter who his quarterback is. This guy was rolling out Mason Rudolph and Duck Hodges and still found a way to, you know, go 500. Still find a way to win 8 games. Like, you gotta show Mike Tomlin love at the end of the day, alright? And it's getting to the point. Listen, I hate to bring up the race card, but let's say if this was, I don't know, Sean McVay or, you know, Kyle Shanahan, one of these coaches that y'all adore, y'all be slurping him all season long. But, you know, the fact that people don't want to show Mike Tomlin his love, or not all the people, it's just frustrating, because this guy, Mike Tomlin, is just as credible as any head coach in the NFL outside Bill Belichick right now. Like, truth be told, Mike Tomlin's probably a top 5 head coach. You can't really name that many head coaches better than Mike Tomlin. I mean, I might take Pete Carroll just as if I... My Seahawks fan in me is going to take Pete Carroll. John Harbaugh is right there. You can throw Andy Reid in there because he won the Super Bowl. But, I mean, not that many coaches are messing with Mike Tomlin. Nobody in their right mind should have Kyle Shanahan and Sean McVay as better head coaches than Mike Tomlin. What did they prove? Mike Tomlin came in year one, won the Super Bowl. This guy, Kyle Shanahan, choked sleeves in the Super Bowl religiously. Kyle Shanahan is the choker of chokers. Sean McVay, you know, got outmatched by Belichick in the Super Bowl. So, like, what are we talking about? But anyway, let's run through the schedule real quick before I go on the full rant. Listen, they'll beat the Giants week one. I think that game is going to be closer than what y'all expect. It's going to be in MetLife. I know fans are not going to be there, but it's going to be a Monday night game. Joe Judge seems like he's going to be Belichick 2.0 or whatever. So, I expect that game to be close. They'll beat the Broncos. They'll beat the Texans. They'll beat the Titans. They'll beat the Eagles. They'll beat the They'll beat the Browns. They'll beat the Ravens in Baltimore. But listen, there won't be fans until probably late in the season. So how I'm looking at things, even though it's in Baltimore, and usually I would ride with the Ravens in Baltimore, but with there being no fans, I expect the Steelers to come in and win. So I got the Steelers starting off 7-0. But I'm that huge on the Steelers. Then they'll drop a game in Jerry World to the Cowboys. They'll beat the Bengals. They'll beat the Jaguars. They'll split with the Ravens. So they'll lose that second game at home. They'll beat the Washington football team. They'll beat the Bills. They'll beat the Bengals again. They'll drop on the Phillip Rivers. And then they'll drop on the Baker Mayfield. They're going 12-4. They're going 12-4. Now, I feel like I'm being quite conservative with that, because maybe they just sweep the Browns. Maybe they beat the Cowboys. I don't know. Maybe they beat the Cowboys. At the end of the day, it's like, I'm rolling with the Steelers, man. I think Steelers going to be one of the best teams in the AFC this year. I really do. I think Big Ben is going to be motivated. There's reports of saying that he lost over 20 pounds of weight. That's, of course, going to be good for Big Ben. Big Ben has been staying away from those quarter pounders. So, you know, that's always good. You know what I'm saying? But at the end of the day, I feel like Mike Tomlin, his defense, and the Steelers overall got something to prove, man. This team has missed the playoffs the past 2 years. I think they do to make the playoffs this year and be true contenders. That's all. Subscribe to the channel if you're new. I'm the Phenomenal One, and I'm out. Deuces. Shout out my Crips, they're still crippin', niggas. Shout out my Bloods, they're still bloodin', niggas. Straight from the dirt, shout out my muddy niggas. Came from the bottom, all my get money niggas. When I die, you ain't got to cry, you just got to pray. Put some weed where I lay, I'ma see you another day. Full of energy, you my enemy, you got to pay. Was on the east side, fucking with them Crips the other day. Was on the